हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द एयर पोल्यूशन एंड सॉलिड वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट सब्जेक्ट। एंड टुडे वी विल सी द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ एयर पोल्यूशन ऑन ह्यूमन एंड नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स। ओके, सो वील बिगिन अप विद दिस इमेज। इट कैन बी क्लियरली सीन दैट द इफेक्ट ऑन द मैन मेड स्ट्रक्चर्स देन, ओके, ऑन लिविंग एंड नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स। First of all, looking towards the human health hazards, you can see that the effect of air pollution is as good as smoking, and it is directly and indirectly affecting the many organs in the body, just like respiratory disorders and maybe cause of indoor air pollution, and then cardiovascular disease may be there. Okay, so exposure to the air pollution is associated with the numerous effects on human health, including pulmonary, cardiac, vascular and neurological impairments. The health effects may greatly from the person to person, even in high risk group such as the elderly, infants, pregnant women and sufferers from chronic heart and lung diseases are more susceptible to air pollution. Children are at greater risk. Generally small babies, you know, below 5 years age are very at high risk, because they are generally more active outdoors and their lungs are still developing. The immunity power and all things are not very much enough to handle all the things, hence the children, they are at high risk regarding the effects on air pollution on human health. Okay, and then exposure to the air pollution can cause both acute short-term and chronic long-term health effects. Okay, then acute effects are usually immediate and often reversible when exposure to the pollutant ends. Some acute health effects include eye irritation, headache, nausea. Then chronic effects are usually not immediate and tend not to be reversible when exposure to the pollutant ends. Some chronic health effects include decreased lung capacity and lung cancer resulting from long-term exposure to toxic air pollution. Okay, so some of the things in which they are directly affected, some of the time it may take time to get affected, but the serious cognizance has to be taken regarding the air pollution. Otherwise, as far as human health is concerned, we may suffer a lot regarding that cancer effect and all the things, toxic air pollution, exactly all the things are there, eye irritation, headache, lungs may get seriously affected. Of air pollution, the main area, you know, main segment that is very badly affected, that is the respiratory system of the human being. You can see detail in the image, the bronchi and alveoli. You can see it is get very seriously in via nose, it is connected, all the things, and both gases and particular air pollutants can have negative effects on the lungs. Solid particles can settle on the walls of the trachea, bronchioles. Continuous breathing of polluted air can show the normal cleaning action of the lungs and results in more particles reaching the lower portion of the lung. That is very dangerous. Damage to the lungs from air pollution can inhibit this process and contribute to the occurrence of respiratory disease such as bronchitis, emphysema and cancer. That is very dangerous. Now, see, the image is clearly showing the danger of lead and arsenic poisoning. Okay, then nerve damage, first of all, then skin damage, problem in the skin, hyperkeratosis, scaling of skin, pigment changes, then cancer risk may increase because of air pollution, lungs, bladder, kidney and liver cancer. So these are the just like invitation to all the diseases if you are living in a area which is surrounded by a lot of pollutants. So these are the indirectly invitations to the lot of diseases and skin problems, circulatory problems in skin, all the things. So it leads to, you know, slow poisoning, you know, high level of lead, mental retardation, coma, all the things, you know, and ultimately it results to death. So it is very, you know, important thing to understand the importance of the air pollution and how to tackle it, how to avoid it, what do and don'ts we have to do, what pro and cons we have to do, what we have to consider as an industrialist, as a businessman, as an engineer, what we are making aware to this society and what we are learning from all this is very important. lower low level of lead again, reduce IQ, attention span, it gets irritated, headache, you know, itching, all the things. So reading and learning disabilities, it may, you know, hearing loss, a lot of things are there which is directly connected with the air pollution. Now this table shows the sources, health and welfare effect on criteria, such as I have described the pollutants in one first column, they said carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen, ozone, lead in particular matter. So these are the five pollutants we have seen, and by combination we also seen the smoke effect is there. So description which is colorless, you know, carbon monoxide is colorless, odorless gas, you know, what is the source, where it is obtaining from, motor vehicle exhaust, indoor sources includes kerosene, wood burning, etc. And effects are, you know, headache, reduced mental alertness, heart attack, cardiovascular diseases, impaired fetal development, death, contribute to formation of smoke and all the things. Okay, then sulfur dioxide, it's also colorless gas that dissolves in water vapor to form acid and interact with other gases and particles in the air. And the source from where it is gets released in the atmosphere, that is coal fire power plants, petroleum refineries, manufacture of sulfuric acid, and smelling of aerosols containing sulfur. Health effects are very bad, just like eye irritations, wheezing, chest tightness, shortness of breath, lung damages, etc. And welfare effects are to contribute to the formation of acid rain, which is harmful for the structures. Even Taj Mahal got affected once due to the acid rain. Then invisibility, apartment plants and water damage, aesthetic damage, very dangerous. Then comes the nitrogen dioxide, it's reddish brown, it is not colorless like, so it is reddish brown, highly reactive gas, it is coming out from motor vehicles, electric utilities, industries, and while burning fuel also. Health effects are very serious, just like susceptibility to respiratory infections, irritation to the lungs and respiratory symptoms, cough, chest pain, you know, breathing, difficulties breathing is something you can shut down. Alright. So contributing to the formation of smoke, acid rain, water quantity deterioration, global warming. So these are the, now as we are going ahead, the seriousness level regarding the effects are getting increased. Now ozone, all right, then gases pollutant when it form in the troposphere. Okay, it is coming out from the vehicle exhaust and certain other fumes formed from other pollutants in presence of sunlight. And the same effect as mentioned above, the eye irritation, throat irritation, coughing, respiratory tract problem, asthma, lungs. So these are the, you know, by default problems caused by the air pollution, and if we are living and working and even going even nearby or surrounding area, so we may face such kind of problem. And the main impact of ozone 3 is on the plants and ecosystem damage. There is an ecosystem built by the nature, you know, God has given the ecosystem. If that get disturbed, then human has to, you know, pay a lot, which can be irreparable. Alright. Then lead, it's a metallic element basically. It comes from metal refineries, lead smelters, battery manufacturers, iron and steel products. Then anemia, high blood pressure, brain and kidney damage. This is one of the very serious, you know, it leads ultimately to a death. Lower IQ, cancer, and affects animal and plants, affect aquatic ecosystem also. Okay, and then particular matters, the very small particles, dust, you know, including droplets of liquid. These are coming out from the diesels, engine, power plant, industries, all the things, you know, again the same effects as mentioned, eye irritation, wheezing, chest, lungs damage, cancer, you know, these kind of things are very difficult to cure, will leads to very serious and very serious disease. Ultimately it may leads to a death of a person, all right, any human being, difficult to, you know, come back and difficult to recover, taking a lot of time. Then visibility, welfare effect, then visibility impairment, atmosphere deposition, aesthetic damage. Okay, again then if you can see that there are many pollutants as I have discussed, then effect, these are the living things. Now we will see the effects on vegetable. Okay, then the pollutants, like I'll just name out all the pollutants like aldehydes, ozone, and peroxyacetyl nitrate, the nitrogen dioxide, ammonia and sulfur dioxide, chlorine, hydrogen fluoride, silicon, tetrafluoride, pesticides and herbicides and particulates and mercury. So these are the, you know, pollutants which are directly having impact over the vegetables, even photochemical reaction, just like you know, pan of the same ozone, then high temperature combustion of oil. So we'll see one by one now the effect of the first one is the aldehydes, and the sources are petrochemical reactions, and it is coming out from the it is coming out from the petrochemical reactions, and the upper portion of the alpha will be affected to nerosis if 250 ppm of aldehyde is present for 2 hours duration. That table we have seen the range of the pollutants, right, from 0 to 50, then 50 to 100, then 100 to 250, and then 500. The seriousness level get increased, and it is of high risk, and it have a very bad impact on the vegetables. Then ozone, then it's a photochemical reaction of hydrocarbon and nitrogen oxide from the fuel combustion, and refuse burning and evaporation from petroleum products, and all age of tobacco leaves, you know, beam, grapes, pine, pumpkins and potato are affected, very badly affected. Ultimately such kind of things, if available in the market and we are eating it, so ultimately the ecosystem get disturbed and we are having very bad impact on our health also. So even it is, you know, spotting, pigmentation, growth, suppression, and clearly, you know, these are the effects. Okay, then so if it is directly affecting on the vegetables, then such kind of things are coming in our contact while our daily diet, so it will be very dangerous for all of us to, you know, remove all the things. Then peroxyacetyl nitrate, the source of PAN are the same as the ozone, which is coming from the burning of fuel combustion, refuse burning. Okay, and Young's poly cells of plants affected, and if 0.01 ppm of PAN is present, PAN means peroxyacetyl nitrate PAN, is present in the ambient air more than 6 hours. Okay, if the gas in this particular are available in the air for more than 6 hours, then this effect is very bad for us. The next one is nitrogen dioxide, NO2, then high temperature combustion of coal, oil gases and gasoline in power plants and internal combustion engines. Okay, so in case of that, the nitrogen dioxide can be produced and will affect on the regular white or brown collapsed lesion of the intercostal. Okay, intercostal tissues near the leaf margin. Suppressed growth is observed in many plants. It is very dangerous. Then ammonia and sulfur dioxide. These are the products from absolutely everybody can guess. They are from thermal power plants and oil and petroleum refineries. Then bleach spots, bleach areas between veins, bleach margins, fluorescence growth suppression, early abscisions and reduction in yield and tissue collapse occur. Again, chlorine, leaks in chlorine storage tank, some of the times, you know, hydrochloric acid mist. If 0.10 ppm is present at least for 2 hours in the atmosphere, then the epidermics and mesophylls of the plant will be affected. Then comes the hydrogen fluoride, silicon tetrafluoride, then phosphorite rock presenting aluminium industry and ceramic work and fiberglass manufacturing. This is also coming out from the fiberglass manufacturing industry, where the epidermics and mesophyll of the grapes, large seeds, fruits, pines and fluorosis in animals occur if 0.001 ppm of HF is present for 5 weeks. Okay, then pesticide and herbicide, these are coming from the agriculture operations that, you know, the we have a distribution and, you know, proper sprinkling of that fertilizers. So in that case it may happen, it may come outside and affect. Okay, then defloration, dwarfation, curling, twisting, growth, reduction and killing of the plants may occur. Plants may die, very serious. Then particularly the cement industry, thermal power plant, blasting, crushing, processing. These are the particular matters coming out from these such construction industries and affect the quality of plants, reduces not even the quality of plants. Even it is the very bad condition of working for human beings also. And reduce vigor, hardness, interference with photosynthesis due to plugging, leaf, stomata and blocking of light. Then mercury. Processing of mercury containing ores, burning of coal and oil, greenhouse crops, the effects on vegetable greenhouse crops, floral parts of all vegetations are affected, oxygen and growth reduction occur in most of the plants. Okay, but these are the effects of many pollutants. We have seen that aldehydes, ozone, peroxyacetyl nitrate, nitrogen dioxide, ammonia and sulfur dioxide, chlorine, hydrogen fluoride, silicon tetrafluoride, and pesticides and herbicides, particulates and mercury. These are the sources, pollutants, and we have seen from where it is obtained, it where it can be found, then effects, how much time they are in surrounding. So we have seen that. So these are the direct and indirect effects on the vegetables. Okay, now if you can see the people, the effects, then for personal exposure, there are two kind of person who smokes and who doesn't smoke. So who non-smoker, they are children, commuter, control, and the commuter, personal car, public transport, walk or cycling from bus stand. Okay, so basically the person who is non-smoker, he has to take care of his children, whether the children is coming nearer. For example, there is a person is smoking nearer to us, and though ultimately we are not smoking, ultimately we are on the same area, we are standing adjacent, so it may affect that 10% of the smoke is coming to my lungs via that, as he is standing closer to me. So that precaution we have to take. And in the ambient level, the indoor environments, outdoor environments, homes, other locations, school, offices, the precaution needs to be taken. Okay, then CET background and hotspots, and support from citizens and support from local authorities, both the things are required. There has to be strict bylaws regarding the smokings and all public places. That's why we have seen on many times that smoking is strictly prohibited. Okay, in burning of coal, fuel, waste, plastic, it is should be strictly prohibited on a public place. There has to be some rules and bylaws, and we have to categorize ourselves, and we have to take care of ourselves. That's the thing. Okay, so these are the categorization of the, you know, personal exposure and ambient levels. Okay, so you can see with the image that, you know, deforestation is also one of the big problem and effect on the structures. Okay, so these are the thing effects on human and like living things and non-living things, even on the plant. If ecosystem get disturbed, then it will be very difficult for us to survive. Okay, these are the things. Then the potential PM effects on the cardiovascular system, that's it. So these are the effect basically on the now the particular matters, potential PM effects. PM stands for particular matters, effects on the cardiovascular system. Numerous epidemiological, biomedical and clinical studies indicates that the ambient particular matters PM in air pollutant is strongly associated with the increased cardiovascular diseases such as myocardial infection, MI, that stands for then cardiac arrhythmias, then ischematic stroke, vascular dysfunction, then hypertension and arcolysis. So these are these things, suddenly, you know, it is get connected with the then ambient particulate matters, then you have two parts, then pulmonary reflexes, then pulmonary inflammation, then again it's subdivided into autonomic nervous system, then conduction repolarization, then heart rate, and then cardiac. You know, it may ultimately results in the heart attack. Okay, then the pumping rate of the heart may reduce down, it may disturb. So you can see in the chart that clotting factor, viscosity and thrombosis, you know, so these are the very bad and, you know, dangerous effects on the human respiratory system. Okay, so we have seen in the today's particular task that how it gets seriously affected the human nervous respiratory system and all. So I hope you understand it, and in upcoming time we have, in upcoming lectures we will see that the how that how the what precautions and what do and don'ts we have to, as engineer we have to suggest and follow in order to control. We cannot stop it 100%, but at least we can control to extent to have a better environment.